So we have a to the negative n.
If you took that a to the negative n and wrote it as a fraction, what would it look like?
1 over a to the n.
So the numerator became the denominator became the numerator, and your negative sign, since you moved that exponent, goes to the other position. So that's what's happening. You're changing the position, and you're also changing your sign.
T to the negative 3.
We don't have to write as a whole number to come up with our answer, but understanding that it can be a whole number is nice. So what do you think is going to change?
The negative.
The negative, or what's it going to become?
Positive.
And when it becomes a positive, what else will happen?
The t is like the same thing as 1. It would be 1 over t to the 3rd.
Exactly. It will become the denominator. D to the negative 5.
1 over d to the 5th. And what if we change the letter to a number?
5 to the negative 3.
1 over 5 to the 3rd.
Now, because this is a number, not a variable, we need to figure out what this 5 cubed is. Mm-hmm. So the power of 3 is only attached to the 5, right? Mm-hmm. So you only have 1 on the top, the numerator, but you have 3 5s on the denominator. So what's 5 times 5?
125.
Times 5 again?
125.
So you're looking at 1 over 125. So we're going to look at 2 problems. They're similar, but they're different. First one we're going to look at is a negative 3. To the power of a negative 2, and we're going to look at negative 3 to the power of negative 2. This one, the negative is going to do exactly what this tells it to do. The 3 is also going to do exactly what this tells it to do. But on this one, the power only goes to the first thing to left. So it's only going to go to the 3. It's not going to go to the negative. Mm-hmm. So when I'm rewriting this problem and I've got this negative power, that negative power is only going to go to the 3. So technically my problem, I'm really going to expand it out, looks like this. Negative 3 to the negative 2. And what do we do with that negative power?
Flip it.
We flip it, make it positive. So what are we going to be flipping? Only this one. That negative, where is it located? Numerator or denominator? It's in the numerator up here, right?
Yeah.
This is also in the numerator, but it changed to the denominator because of that negative power. This negative stays on top. So it ends up being negative 1 over 3 squared, which is negative 1 over 9. So if I jump down to this example to do a comparison, the first thing to left of that negative 2 is the parentheses. So everything inside that parentheses is affected by that negative 2.
Okay.
So on this one, we've got the power, which is a negative. Mm-hmm. What is going to move is not just the 3, but the negative 3. So this one is going to become 1 over negative 3 squared. Now this power of 2 is still affected by both of these. So it becomes 1 over negative 3 times negative 3. There's two of them. Negative 3 times negative 3?
9.
What type of 9? Positive or negative?
Positive.
Your sign changes. No. Sign changes because of that parenthesis. That's the difference. What would happen if our negative exponent was in the denominator?
Yeah, d to the n power over 1.
And do we really see a 1 at the denominator?
No.
What do we see?
Yeah.
We see b to the n. All right, so in the next set of problems, we actually have both items. So let's try an example. R to the negative 3 over 2 to the negative 4. You can do them one at a time, you can do them all together, your choice. So that r to the negative 3 has a negative exponent in the numerator. So if I'm going to change that negative exponent to a positive, where's the r going to end up?
On the bottom.
On the bottom. And what is it going to look like on the bottom?
R to the third.
R to the third power. Now the 2 to the negative 4, to make it a positive exponent, where's it going to end up?
On top.
And what's it going to look like?
2 to the fourth.
2 to the fourth. And what is 2 to the fourth?
16.
And there's your answer. T to the negative 3 over T to the negative 5. So the first thing that we're going to do is get rid of our negatives. Then we're going to reduce. So first getting rid of the negatives, what's going to happen?
Flip it.
We're going to flip it. So what is it going to become?
T to the fifth over T to the third.
T to the fifth over T to the third. Now we need to reduce. I'm going to go old school way. What does that 5 mean in the numerator? Exactly. You've got 5 T's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Factor.
And they're all held on by multiplication.
Cancel.
Yes. So how many T's do you have in the denominator?
3.
So that answer would become just T to the second.
1 T cancels with 1 T. Keep going as many times as you can. It leaves you with 2 T's on the top, that imaginary one on the bottom, or a T squared as your final answer. Now, is there a shorter way to do that? You can also subtract. So you can then take the problem and say, okay, we have a T to the 5, and then I'm gonna bring this 3 up and subtract. Remember, when you bring it up, your sign switches, right? It becomes that negative that you kind of really already had.
Yeah.
So you have a T squared. So a couple different ways, or 2 different ways to do it. 4x to the negative 2. Do you see a parentheses?
No.
So since you don't see a parentheses, that power negative 2 is attached onto what? Remember, what makes this problem different from this one? What's the difference between the two problems?
It's the whole thing.
Exactly. This denominator here, and every time you see a power, you look at the first thing to left. First thing to left is this parentheses. That means the 4 and the x get this negative 2. First thing to left of this problem is just the x. The 4 is the second thing to left. So your negative 2 only goes to the x. So if you separate this, it's really 4 and an x to the negative 2. So what happens with the 4?
It goes along to the right.
It stays.
Stays exactly where it is. Mm-hmm. And where is it? In the numerator. Mm-hmm. What about the x? Where does it, what happens to it?
It flips.
Why?
Because of the negative.
Because of the negative. So the 4 stays, and what is the x and negative 2 going to look like?
Yeah.
X squared. But where is it?
On the bottom.
So what's on the top?
The 4.
And we're going to do a 1, and then we'll blend them together. So then this will become 4 over x squared. All right, so on this one, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change my negative 3 to a positive 3, which means everything inside that parentheses is going to flip. The denominator will become the numerator. The numerator will become the denominator. Right?
Okay.
Then I'm going to use my quotient rule and bring that power 3 to everything. How many items do you see inside that parentheses? You got the T. You got the 3, you got the x squared. The x squared is attached together.
Okay, then it's 3.
So that 3 is going to go to the t, it's going to go to the 3, and it's going to go to the x squared. It's going to go to every single item. So, all right, so simplifying, you then have t cubed. 3 to the power 3 is 27. How many x's are you going to have now? Remember, you have 2 on the inside, a 3 on the outside.
You multiply the power of 3 times 6.
There you go.
That's what it is.